So we know that the CO2 we pump into the atmosphere is changing the climate, but it's also changing things underwater. Think about it. We may only swim at the beach a couple times a year, but the oceans cover 70% of the Earth's surface full time and contain somewhere between 50 and 80% of the world's life forms. 1 to 3 billion people rely on oceans for food or livelihood, and well, all the rest of us just pee in it. When CO2 from the air is absorbed into seawater, it dissolves and becomes carbonic acid. It's basically like one of those soda machines adding carbonation to a bottle of seltzer. The cartridge of CO2 spurts gas into the water, which adds bubbles and makes it slightly more acidic. We are doing this to the oceans on an enormous scale. Over the last couple of centuries, the oceans have absorbed a quarter of the CO2 we've emitted, and their average pH has dropped from 8.2 to 8.1. That may not sound like a lot, but the pH scale is logarithmic, which means a drop of 1/10 is nearly a 30% increase in acidity. When water becomes more acidic, it becomes harder for certain sea creatures to form their shells. This is especially true for coral polyps, the tiny creatures that build reefs, the ocean's most productive ecosystems. When polyps struggle to build their hard exoskeletons, reefs stop growing or begin to shrink, leaving them vulnerable to other threats. Other animals are vulnerable to small changes in ocean chemistry too. Experiments have shown that certain kinds of fish get lost more easily, are more anxious, and have a harder time finding food. This isn't all hypothetical either. Pteropods, tiny swimming snails that make up the base of many marine food chains, are already starting to dissolve. The combination of all these factors spells out major danger for the oceans. While scientists have experimented with ways of offsetting some of the damages of acidification, like planting seagrass meadows or basically using Alka-Seltzer to fight the ocean's acid reflux, the only real solution is to cut down on the CO2 in the atmosphere. It always comes back to that, doesn't it? Hang in there, Little Dipper.